Hi everyone, I assume that if you're watching this video, it means that you're already climate change aware, and there is no need for me to convince you that climate change is something important or that each of us should be more responsible towards the environment. I guess that all of you, as well as I am, already is afraid of what is happening because of the climate change. I mean, this increased fires, increased floodings, and even the change of the seasons. I guess all of you must be missing spring this year, and maybe spring is already here. It's really warm autumn. So instead of talking or convincing you of why climate change is aware, I would rather speak more about other aspects of climate change, which is the economic benefits for each of us and for the country in general. Before talking about the this aspect of the climate change, I would like to introduce myself and why information which I will tell you is more or less credible. My name is Alina Sviderska. I am a green energy expert. I have been working in green energy sphere for around 5 or 6 years with different stakeholders. I started as an activist. I was working for the NGO right after the revolution. Then I was working also with the government. We were volunteering my NGO with the cabinet of ministers, with the parliament. And after that, I shifted into business, so I know how it works from the business side. What I also know about the economics is that, surprisingly, in Ukraine, I work in the green energy sphere, this industry has been a little bit demonized for the last year or two. And the reason for that is that our government is saying that green energy is too expensive. So I'm here to tell you that it's more expensive to develop other spheres of energy compared to the green one. So before talking about the details, I will say where are we right now and what green energy fits into Ukraine. So this is Ukrainian like infographics of how the energy map looks. And the majority of our generation is nuclear and coal. In Ukraine, we have 15 nuclear reactors, and out of them, 13 are already old and working beyond their lifespan, which means that they require modernization, and we need money for modernization. The government has to find money somewhere. And speaking about the coal, which is also a huge generation in Ukraine, all of the plants are very old. They are older than 40 years. So all our Ukrainian generation is very old. Old and dirty, and actually quite expensive because we need to have money to find and modernize it. So of all the generation we have, the only new is green energy. During the last 2 or 3 years, we got a lot of investors, and we have around 6 or 7 gigawatts of new capacities, and this is the only new technologies which we have. When I speak about green energy, I mean solar, wind, hydro. Hydro is not that developed in Ukraine, but still. And also the new transmission lines, new transformers, basically the whole infrastructure which is required for green energy. Also, another interesting thing is that green energy is not as expensive as being told. It's actually vice versa. Green energy is contributing a lot to the economy. So apart from creating a lot of workplaces, there are around 30,000 workplaces in Ukraine. This includes engineers, lawyers, environmental experts, and all sort of professions. They're also paying a lot of taxes. So here is the table which compares of what, for example, the coal is contributing to the economy and what green energy is contributing to the economy. And you can see that coal is actually taking more from the budget than given to it, while green energy is paying more taxes. So it's actually beneficial. And this is one thing which very few politicians are telling us right now, and which very few people are actually digging into the details. And if we look also into the economics of the foreign direct investments in Ukraine, green energy is the only sphere which brought so many foreign investors. I think that during the last several years, they like 30% of foreign investments are coming from green energy. Also, when we're speaking about the cost of the construction, you might very often hear something like, oh, we can use cheap nuclear, but is it so cheap? Recently in the news, there was information that our government is planning to build another 2 nuclear reactors. Probably this is a good strategy because this will provide a lot of workplaces, but is it so cheap? If you look into the economics of how much does it cost, Actually, green energy is the cheapest one to build. The most expensive is coal, then goes nuclear, and then green. So green energy is probably the fastest technology where the costs of construction are reducing. I think that the line would go like that. So if maybe 3 years ago, the cost was 20 euro cents per kilowatt, now it's, it's disappearing. Now it's 6 euro cents. So, I mean, for everyone, for environment, for the government, for business, for citizens, it's very beneficial, the green energy and the climate change. And probably this is my key message for you. So anytime you hear discussions about what is green energy and what it means for the climate change, you should always think about the numbers, and that even in terms of the numbers, it's all is beneficial for all of us.